Now, I will show the 440 busbar is giving power to another section. You can see the power is flowing from there and it's straight coming down. Okay, to this green color ESB. What is ESB? So you should note that point that breaker is open. It means that from that busbar power is coming till that point only. It is not coming to the busbar. But in the other side, you can see that the breaker is closed. So what you can make out from this? That is, this busbar is getting power from starboard 440 volt busbar. That we can change as per our scenario. Okay, suppose if starboard busbar failed and port side busbar is having power, so that time we can close the breaker which is opened in the port side. The red breaker we can close and give power to the emergency switch. That depends upon our situation. Okay, so you know, you can easily that 440 ESB, that is 440 volt ESB, is a single busbar. As I said, there is no split in the ESB. So what is basically an ESB is an emergency switchboard. So emergency switchboard, whatever consumers will be connected in the emergency switchboard, which we need essential consumers only, basically like starting air compressor, emergency lightings. So you should note the point that this is a 440 volt emergency switchboard busbar. So our emergency lightings are not going to work from 440. We need, for that we need 230. So now that I will come to later. The second thing is that you see the starboard busbar is giving power to the emergency switchboard. Suppose our starboard busbar failed, so that breaker, that green color breaker, this will open and the red color breaker will close. So these breakers are known as interlock breakers. Means these have connection to the two sides with one closed, one NC and one NO. Okay, and you can see a one guy in the middle of two these connections interlock. That is the EG, emergency generator. Okay, so what is the capacity of emergency generator here? You can make out it's 276 kilowatt. So you should always see our all other generators are of 1800 kilowatt and our emergency generator is only 276 kilowatt. What may be the reason? Because we need emergency generator to supply only the essential consumers. We are not going to run the emergency generator for thruster motors, nothing. Okay, suppose our ship is unfortunately, we get a fire on board and we need to launch our lifeboat. For the lifeboat need to launch, we need emergency power. So that emergency power is taken from the emergency switch. So as I said, as per the SOLAS requirement, if both busbars failed, our emergency generator should come on load, start, it should start and it should come on load within 45 seconds and it should start giving power to the emergency busbar. Okay, this is a very important point. You should always remember that emergency generator should start within and come on load within 45 seconds and it should give power to its consumers. So as I said, we have 440 volt single busbar and from there are many consumers like starting main air compressor. There will be two main air compressors. One will be connected to the emergency switchboard and one will be connected to the main switchboard. And this rescue boat davit motor and the breathing air compressors, like there's so many emergency consumers are connected, 440 are connected in this emergency switchboard. And you can easily see that again we have two transformers that is connected from emergency switchboard. Obviously right now in this situation you can make out why we are using these transformers. Yes, it's we are again stepping down 440 volt to 230 volt and giving this supply to the 230 volt emergency switchboard busbar. So we can give the emergency supply lighting to all the emergency lightings. Okay, for that we have two transformers and again as I explained before, there is an input and output breakers for both transformers, primary side and secondary side. Okay, so this is how I hope you are understanding my point. If you have any doubt, you can put it in the comment section, or you can directly ask me on my WhatsApp number. No issue. I always feel free to help you guys. So this is basically the section of the 440 volt, which I already explained, the emergency generator connected and the emergency generator bus bars, main bus bars. And now what are these two power connections? I already told that we have two giant thrusters, each of 2000 kilowatt. How this guy is going to run? He needs enormous power. For that, it is directly connected to the 440 volt bus bar. So you should check the rating. One thruster itself is taking the power of 2000 kilowatt, which means that our old one generator itself cannot supply power to that generator, no, to that thruster. So we should always run two generators in parallel, okay, in order to make one thruster start. So this is the basic idea. Okay, I hope you all understand how that. So again, I forgot to tell you what is this symbol. You can make out that there is a transformer, and this transformer symbol is not a simple transformer symbol. It's a star delta transformer, which I will later explain you how, what is the purpose of star delta transformer. And we have a VFD symbol. Below that we have a VFD. What is VFD? Is a variable frequency drive motor. This 2000 kilowatt motor is start and run through the VFD principle, which I will explain you very detailed. It's a very simple principle. Like we have starters for the motor. You already learned about star delta, auto transformer, dual, and everything, soft starters. So it's like VFD is like also a starting technique. It's a very efficient and it's a very trending technique now. Almost many of the vessels are converting to electric propulsion, and this is how the electric propulsion vessel shape distribution is looks like. Okay, so I'll come up with more videos. See, I always like to put practical real videos. I'm not interested to give you guys big theories and anything that you might be already learning from your institutes. So basically an ETO needs to be learned from the practical side, actually. It's, I believe so. So I'll come up with new videos regarding the practical videos and how the engine room looks like, how the thruster motors looks like, what is the duty of an ETO, how is the life of an ETO. Hope everyone liked my video. Please share and subscribe.